Let's learn how to set up client-side routing with React Router for your universal web application. Given that you have server-side routing already set up, the obvious next step is enable routing on the client side. Now, before we do that, let's refactor our React Router routes into its own file since it's going to be shared on both the server and the client. Let's cut the routes and replace it with the exports of the module we'll be creating. Save the file and then create the module routes.jsx inside the routes directory. Open the new file and paste the routes. Make sure to export the route configuration and feel free to format the code so it's more readable. At the top of the file, don't forget to require React and then React Router. This should now work. But before I continue, let me first tidy up my code. Feel free to follow along if you like. I'm going to create a variable for each React Router component used in the file. We have router, which is the primary React Router component that keeps your UI and URL in sync. We have route, which is used to declaratively map a route or path to a component. And we have browser history, which uses HTML5 history API if found. Alternatively, you can use hash history, which uses URL hashes. Now, we no longer need React Router dot in our JSX code, and this makes our routes more readable. Save the file and open client.js. As a reminder, this is the entry file for our module bundler when we build our client-side script. Let's update the file to render our routes. First, there's no need to require React anymore, since routes.jsx is an element rather than a component. Now, let's require our routes. I'm also going to remove props since it's no longer being passed anywhere. Accordingly, let's update React DOM to render our routes elements into the document. Save the file and switch to your browser. Refresh the page and although everything still looks the same, we unfortunately have invariant violation errors. Remember that invariant violation occurs when the rendered elements do not match. In this case, the server side does not match the client side because the props from the server are no longer being accounted for on the client. In other words, we'll need to bring back window.props. But this time, we'll be passing the client-side props in routes.jsx. We'll need to use router's createElementProp, which will allow us to control the creation of the router element. Since this file is also used on the server side, we'll need to add some logic to ensure that createElement only works on the client side. There are a few ways to check if you're in the browser, but a quick and easy way is to confirm that window is a global and an object. This works because there's no window on Node unless it's polyfilled. Inside the if statement, create the function which accepts two parameters, the router component and the router props. Let's return the component element with the props spread out and merge with window.props. Save the file and switch back to your browser. Refresh the page once more and you'll see that the console errors are now gone. You can go to the elements panel and look inside the script tag to see all the server props rendered as a JSON to window.props. If you have React DevTools installed, you can also check there to see your component's props. Finally, you can click the button to ensure that your alert is still working. Now, before I end this video, I do want to mention that you don't have to render the router props and window.props for the universal application to still work. All you need is your server props, which is title in our case. And that's all it takes to set up client-side routing with React Router for a universal web application.